the previous video class you learned how to balance a chemical equation. In this class we shall study about types of chemical reactions. In chemical reactions, breaking and making of bonds between them, they can be categorized into four types. Now come to types of chemical reactions. The first type is combination reaction. Second is decomposition reaction. Third is displacement reaction. Fourth is double displacement reaction. Now come to first reaction, that is combination reaction. See children, here the name itself indicates combination. Combination means combined. Here two or more reactants combine together to form a single product. Such kind of reaction is called combination reaction. See, for example, here calcium oxide vigorously react with the water to produces calcium hydroxide and with release heat energy. See children, here the calcium oxide is called quicklime. Quicklime vigorously react with the water to produces calcium hydroxide is called slaked lime. This slaked lime is used for whitewashing of walls. Children, all of you heard the word the whitewashing of the walls. Here this is used for whitewashing because this calcium hydroxide reacts carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere to produce or to form calcium carbonate layer on the walls after 2 to 3 days. It gives shiny thick layer on the walls. Due to that reason, this slaked lime used for whitewashing of walls. See children, here in this example, heat is liberated. This kind of reactions are called exothermic reactions. Listen once again. During the reaction, heat energy is liberated. That kind of reaction is called exothermic reaction. For example, burning of natural gas. The natural gas is going to burn with the help of oxygen present in the atmosphere. It produces carbon dioxide and water vapor with releasing heat energy. In the same way, our respiration process is also an example for exothermic reaction, and decomposition of vegetable matter is also an example for exothermic reaction. Listen once again, exothermic means heat is liberated during the reaction. Children, now come to second type of the reaction, that is decomposition reaction. Here the single reactant breaks down to give the simpler products. A single reactant is broken down into simpler products. Such kind of reaction is called decomposition reaction. Now come to the example. Here the limestone breaks into calcium oxide and with releasing of carbon dioxide gas. Here the reaction takes place by absorbing heat energy. With the help of heat energy, this going to breaks down into quicklime and releasing carbon dioxide. And observe the second example, the lead nitrate. It also going to break down with absorbing heat energy. It gives the lead oxide and nitrogen dioxide gas and with oxygen liberated. In these two reactions, here the heat energy is used. This kind of the reaction is known as thermal decomposition reaction. Observe children, here the decomposition takes place with the help of heat energy. This kind of reactions are called thermal decomposition reaction. Now come to another example, electrolysis of water. During the electrolysis of water, the electricity is used and here water breaks down into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. In the same way, We go to the another example. The silver chloride, the white silver powder is exposed to sunlight. It turns to gray color. For breaking down the silver chloride into silver and chloride gas. Okay, now come to third reaction, displacement reaction. This reaction is explained through the example. Take for example iron dipped in copper sulfate solution. Copper sulfate solution is in blue color. The iron dipped in copper sulfate solution, after some time the iron take oxide. The color of this iron might become brownish color and the color of the copper sulfate solution do get fade. This is due to because the iron displaces copper from the solution to produces iron sulfate and copper. Observe here, the iron is more stronger than copper. Iron is displaces the copper from the solution. In the same way, zinc reacts with the copper sulfate solution. The zinc displaces the copper from the solution to produce zinc sulfate and copper. In the same way, lead also reacts with the copper chloride solution to produce lead chloride and copper. Observe, in these reactions, the stronger element displaces the weaker element from the solution. Here, the reactivity or the strong is plays very important role to displaces one element by the other. Which is more stronger, that displaces the weaker element from the solution. Listen, children, displacement reaction means which element is stronger, that displaces the weaker element from the solution. Okay, now come to third reaction, that is double displacement reaction. This reaction takes place when the ions get exchanged between the reactants. See children here, for example, sodium sulfate solution reacts with the barium chloride solution. It gives barium sulfate and sodium chloride aqueous solution. In this reaction, ions get interchanged. Look at here, sodium ions get attached with the chlorine to form sodium chloride. In the same way, sulfate ions get attached with barium ions to form barium sulfate solid product. Here we observe the ions get exchanged between them to form the new product. Such kind of reaction is known as double displacement reaction. Listen once again, in double displacement reaction, the ions get exchanged between them to produce new substance. Okay children, till now we discussed about the types of chemical reactions such as combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction and double displacement reaction. I think all of you understood. In your next class, we will discuss about the remaining concept of this chapter. Thank you.